Sujata, you just heard how we've essentially spoken about this, your role in it, and as part of the Beto ecosystem. Tell us what surprises you most when you deal with your members. How are you able to guide them to make better choices?
Thank you for this question. What surprises me the most is people when it comes to diabetes, they take this condition as this is because of taking much sugar, right? Most of the people are unaware of this fact that this is because of insulin resistance when we talk about type 2 diabetes, right? And they think that every diet works similar for every person. And most of the, I've come across many people who are taking the same medication as if their family members are taking or any of the relatives they are taking. So they are not ready to go to the expert either when it comes to doctor expertise or when it comes to nutritionist expertise or diabetes educator expertise. They rather focus on making changes by themselves and whatever they have heard from the YouTube, whatever they have heard from their relatives. This is what is the most challenging part in making the change, in letting them know that this is your body is different. You need different approach when it comes to a personalized nutritional or personalized medical therapy. So these are the changes, the psychological changes is the most challenging aspect I
Right.
can say when it comes to making the changes. Because one, if you're not you can say strong from your mind and you're not aware about diabetes, very, very difficult for person to convince them to make changes. This is the most surprising, basically we can say that the aspect when it comes to communicating with the patient. Now we are coming, and now the next point is how we make them to start with the changes. So first of all, just focus what is your goal? What do you want to make changes? You want a change in your overall improvement in health, you want a change, you want to improve your sugar levels, you want to make sure that your weight is under control. So just make small goals. I'm not talking about very large goals. Take small steps, work towards them, and when it comes to diabetes, monitoring is the key. So if you have monitored your sugar levels, most of the people will be able to specifically take control over their diabetes. Because if you don't know anything, you won't be able to work on it. And give yourself some time, because I know that when somebody knows about diabetes, it comes them as a shock, right? So why it happened? It's like they have lots of questions. So talk to your doctor, talk to your educator about what are the possible, you can say, the hindrances you are facing, what kind of a psychological impact diabetes has put on you. So these are the basic things I specifically advise them to talk to us, and also advise them to make small changes. Don't go with larger changes. Make small changes in diet, see the impact, motivate
Very
yourself,
true.
and then go for larger goals. Don't think that making changes in diet in one day will give you impact and you will be in a non-diabetic condition. No, that won't happen in one day, because diabetes, when it comes to type 2 diabetes, it doesn't happen in one
And
day. It's a
Sujata, that
slow
certainly
and
is the
progressive
right approach
condition.
because, like you said, that achieving smaller goals is and does look far more achievable. Sujata and Rajiv, I want to thank you for speaking to us as we move on, Shravan. Beto is helping
Thank you so
several
much.
Indians beat diabetes and regain control of their health.